mission statement. And I told you that a mission statement is a precise statement that describes why an organization exists. It answers questions like, why do we exist as an organization? That is the reason for the existence. Whom do we serve? Clients or customers? Then what type of service do we offer? And what do we want to become? What do we want to achieve? In short, it is a clear statement of the purpose for which the organization was set up. We also looked at characteristics of a mission statement. We said it should be clear of the present purpose of the organization without restricting the future. We also said it should be broad in nature, should identify who the organization customers are, should be challenging but achievable, should be supported by all the stakeholders. I'm just giving a summary since we looked at it last time. We also said should a good mission statement should be inspiring in order to meet a cause. It should also focus on meeting customers' need. Should be concise and precise. And should target people, not outputs, etc. So today, let us continue where we stopped last time. We had started the topic of why do organizations change their mission statement. So let us look at more points and then we shall continue from there. Why does an organization change mission statement? We had looked at some points and we said, generally speaking, organizations change their mission statement after the performance declines. There is a tendency to retain the current conditions or even in the face of strong evidence suggesting that the fundamental and significant changes are needed. Then we said in these situations, executives may not recognize the role of the new mission statement. So they decide to change it in order to reverse the firm's performance so that it can improve. After the performance has declined, they design a new mission statement to improve the firm's performance. Also looked at organizations change their mission statement to be more specific if it is too broad. And we looked at some examples. Also looked at to broaden the mission, you may find that an organization realizes its mission statement is too narrow, and in fact, the organization wants to provide services or products related to the original statement, but not included in it. So it has to design a new mission statement reflecting the new products. Then we also said addressing changing times, updating language, addressing a merger or split, then external pressure from donors. If the organization has achieved its mission statement, then it changes to a new one. It needs a new mission statement. If an organization is disbanded and reorganized into an organization, it also needs a new mission statement. If the organization has intentions of changing its focus, it also has to change the mission statement. Then change in business, as we have said, if you change your business, you have been operating like a hardware, but you change, then you have to put in place a new mission statement. If the mission statement has expired, when the target group has changed, etc. So these are the reasons why organizations change their mission statements. So today, let us look at developing a mission statement, the process, the systematic process of developing a mission statement. Suppose you have been appointed by an organization to design a mission statement on their behalf. Which processes would you follow? You cross-check in your handout, and that is page 10. Process of designing a mission statement. Process number one, invite staff meeting. Staff involving all the employees, inform them of the pending strategic planning process. After inviting the meeting, you appoint a task force of 5 members from different departments. If the committee consists of more than 5 members, it may become hard. So because they say too many cooks spoil the soup. Then you carry out what we call a PESTEL analysis. PESTEL analysis is political, economic, then S stands for sociological, technological, ecological, legal, and internal analysis. Then you draft a task force. The task force drafts a mission statement, and the mission statement is no wrong, is not yet final. After carrying out the analysis, see the issues involved in the political, economic, sociological, technological, ecological, legal, and internal analysis, then you draft the committee members draft the mission statement. Then you again invite staff members to share the draft mission. Share same draft with the peers for input. Then they give you the input. It is a process where step one follows step two. Then incorporate stakeholder ideas into the draft mission after consultation. You update the staff on the second and third draft to drive consensus. The chairperson of the task force submits final draft mission statement through a presentation to the board of directors for approval. The board approves the mission statement. Then the chief executive or the chairperson of the task force communicates to the staff through notes boards, monthly meetings, central and personal files. Then you carry out internalization through retreats, seminars, workshops, meetings, so that you sensitize all the employees about the mission statement you have developed. Then it is not yet over. Maybe members, those ones who have just joined, we are looking at the systematic process. And as I've said, this process, step one follows step two. Step two follows step three, 1, 2, 3. So if I rush, you will not be knowing the whole process. Let me repeat all the steps I've mentioned again. Then next time we shall add on more steps and you understand the whole process of making a mission statement. You first invite staff.